holidays are coming up and everyone is in a joyful and happy mood, but that might not be you this year. Today I want to talk to you about how to navigate the holidays whenever you have experienced loss. Now, this is something that I know too well. My father passed away about 2 years ago, and I know exactly what it feels like to have to go through a holiday that is completely different than any other holiday before it. So that's what we're going to talk about today. Hey there, my friends, and welcome back to The Renewed Mind. My name is Ashley, and I am your host here. And today I want to talk to you about navigating through loss, especially during the holidays. Now, I know that this is a topic that isn't going to be for everybody, but if you are struggling with loss right now, I know that the holidays can very much trigger feelings and really heighten a lot of the loss that you've experienced, even if it hasn't happened just recently. So about 2 years ago, actually right after Christmas in 2022, I lost my father, and it was definitely the most difficult thing that has ever happened to me. He was young. He was only 62, and his death came very unexpectedly. He didn't have any big issues or warning signs or red flags that we had seen or anything like that, but he did pass away of a heart attack. And it happened right after the holidays of 2022, so I had an entire year to process the loss, but I definitely still felt that first Christmas, the first everything, right, of the first year was definitely a struggle for me. And so I now want to share with you, if you're in this place, I want to encourage you and help you today. So let's jump into what do we do whenever we're struggling with the holidays? We don't even really want to feel joyful, right? There are definitely challenges that come with holiday grief. And I guess that's what I'm going to keep referring to this feeling as is holiday grief, because it can be really difficult when you have all the festivities and happy things that are going on, but there's this inner grief that is compounded by your loss. So there's definitely the obvious feeling of sadness and being just maybe in a depressed state, but there's also feelings of loneliness that can come in. And whenever you have done things with a specific person for years and years, traditions that are now are broken because there's someone missing, maybe the person who used to always pray at the dinner table for the food, whatever it is, there's different things that trigger different people. And this holiday grief that comes in shows up in a lot of different forms. So there's going to be sadness, there's going to be loneliness, but there can also be some sense of guilt that comes in, because we almost feel guilty of having joy during a season. Whenever my father passed away, I had to move forward right away. We were fostering at the time, and I actually had to take one of our foster kids to an appointment just days after, like 2 days after my father passed away. We had a business that we were running. I had 5 kids in my home. And so there was a lot of times where I felt guilty if I grieved and guilty if I didn't grieve. I felt guilty if I was grieving because I had children that I had to take care of. I had to be helping them in their grief. I had to be, you know, still doing laundry and still doing all the day-to-day tasks that came in. But then I felt guilty if I wasn't grieving because I felt like it said something about how I felt about my dad. And it wasn't until I did a lot of mindset work and really worked through and journaled through a lot of my grief that I realized that the way I expressed that grief had very little to do with the relationship that I had with my dad. So I had an amazing father. I had a great relationship with him. I texted him and talked to him almost every day. And the loss was very clear to me, and I was grieving it, but there were certain things that I needed to do that, because life still goes forward, right? And I know that if you're struggling with loss right now, you understand this probably even more internally than I am, because I'm a little bit away from my loss. You know, I've had several years now to deal with it. But if you are right in the middle of it, it can almost create some feelings of guilt and resentment of other people when you just want the world to stop. You want the world to just pause for a second so that you can deal with this grief, so you can work through this loss, and then you can get back to quote unquote normal. There was a verse that I went back to over and over during the time that I was really in the thick of my grief and my loss. And that verse was Psalm 34:18. And it says, "The Lord is close to the brokenhearted." There are going to be people in your life that they come in and they surround you whenever you're going through loss and suffering. I had people in my life that were like that. But then there are going to be people who your grief, it makes them uncomfortable. And it doesn't mean anything about you. It doesn't mean anything about them. It just means that they're at a place where they can't, it's too uncomfortable for them. So there's going to be times whenever there are people who, in your grief, they step away from you. And this is not in judgment. I'm just seeing observations, but I'm so thankful that God is not like that. In his word, he says he is close to the brokenhearted. He comes to you. He comes close to you. And that's something that if you are dealing with a challenging holiday season, I want to encourage you to lean in to God. Over the last about 18 months, I started writing down some of the things that I had been learning about grief because I didn't want my loss and my pain to go without having an eternal impact. And so I actually put all of the things that I had learned in a book. It's called Not Without Hope. If you want to pick it up, it's available on Amazon. You can get the audio version, the ebook version. But what it is it's a practical guide knowing how to navigate grief through the light of eternity. So we as believers can have a different view of grief because we have an eternal perspective. And what I found during my season of grief was a lot of resources about grief and loss that were secular sources, but I needed something that was going to speak to the eternal aspect of my grief. And that's what this book does. So if you need that, if you know someone who needs it, I'll leave a link in the description for you. Now I want to share some strategies for you to cope during holiday grief. The first strategy that I have is for you to create new traditions. I want you to think about ways that you can honor your lost loved one and create new traditions. They don't have to replace the old ones, but maybe you light a candle at the dinner table or on your mantle that reminds you of someone. Maybe there's a special ornament that you want to purchase or create that you want to put on your tree. It could even be something as simple as sharing a story about your loved one around a room or a circle. Something that I've seen that has been so healing for me is whenever people allow me the space to share about my dad. Now, sometimes, you know, you might feel uncomfortable sharing or you don't know how people feel, but I have specific people in my life that one in particular I just saw a couple months ago, and she sat down and just listened and gave me space to share about my dad. She wasn't like overly weepy or anything like that. She was just there to listen and to let me share. And if you can find a way to create that as a tradition in your family where everybody sits down and remembers their favorite thing about Papa or the funniest story about Uncle whoever, whatever it is that's going to help you to create new traditions at the same time honoring your loved one. The second strategy that I have for you in coping with holiday grief is to allow yourself space and time to feel. I want you to give yourself permission to feel all of the feelings again. So I know that for me, whenever I experienced the first anniversary of my father's death, it was a time that was there was about a couple hours where I was by myself, where I really almost relived my grief as a way of just healing in that process. It was something that I needed, and it was very deeply personal to me. But we have to allow ourselves permission to do these things. Sometimes whenever we've put our feelings away, it can be easy to just kind of think if I bring it back, it's never going to go away. But healing doesn't mean never grieving. Healing doesn't mean that you just have completely forgotten about the person. Healing just means that you can bring back memories without it completely crippling your life. One scripture that I love is Ecclesiastes 3, 1 through 4. And you might be familiar with this, but there's a time for everything. There's a season for everything. And these verses say, a time to mourn and a time to dance. Now, there are so many examples that I could give, but what I want you to do is remember that there are times and seasons that you can mourn. Give yourself permission to feel that. But on the opposite side, there are times and seasons of joy. And so I want you to give yourself permission to feel that too. It's not just giving yourself permission to mourn, but it's giving yourself permission to dance too. The third strategy that I have for coping during holiday grief is to lean into your church family, your faith community. I want you not to isolate yourself. It is so important for us to let other people in and to not just kind of hide ourselves away. It is easy to do, but it's not healthy to do. You need to let others give you the support that you need. I remember, and I shared in my book about a friend who it was during Father's Day, and there was someone who was praying. We were all kind of in a small group setting, and they were just giving thanks for all the fathers. And she just reached over and squeezed my hand because she knew that this was likely going to be something that would trigger the loss that I was feeling. Now, it wasn't something huge, and it didn't attract the attention of everybody in the room, but it made me feel seen and acknowledged, and it made my loss feel acknowledged. And I'm so grateful for that. And I want to remember those kind of gestures because those are the things that I wouldn't have received if I didn't have a church family. And so I remember that day like it was yesterday and how much it just filled my heart with love and encouragement during that hard day. Galatians 6:2 says, carry each other's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ. And that's what we do whenever we go to church. This is just kind of a side note, but if you're someone who feels like you can do just fine without going to church, let me tell you that I have had so much of support and love from my church family that it's not that if I didn't have them, I wouldn't be serving the Lord. That's not true. But they make the journey so much sweeter, so much better, so much more encouraging. And so if you're struggling with finding a church family, I want to encourage you to really dig deep and work to find that because it is an invaluable part of being a believer that we have that community. So make sure that you're not missing out on that. Truly, the best coping strategy that I can give you is to remember that God is with you, not just every day, but during the holidays. Remember that His presence is going to be what brings you peace. And this peace can come even in the midst of your grieving and your loss. That's something that I really found so true in my own grief journey, that the Lord was always right there with me. His faithfulness was so evident to me. And I can remember having a conversation with a friend a year or so before my dad passed away, and I remember telling her how good God had been to me all my life and how so much of who He was and who He is, how that translated to me of His goodness. And I remember talking to that same friend a couple of months after my dad passed and telling her, it's still true. God is still so good to me. And you might be thinking, how could you say that whenever you've had a loss? And for me, it was a very traumatic loss. My dad was not someone who was just not a part of my life. He was very much a part of my life and my kids' lives. And so it was definitely a traumatic loss for me. But I know who my God is. And I know where my dad is. And so that makes all the difference whenever I'm thinking about grieving. I don't grieve like someone who doesn't have hope. And that's the point of this entire book, is saying we grieve, but not without hope. We can grieve and go through the process of grieving and healing always with the umbrella of hope over our grief. And I want that for you. Again, if you're struggling with this loss and you want to go deeper, I really want to encourage you to pick up my book because I believe that it can impact Christians specifically who are dealing with grief. And I want to encourage you to share any comments or stories. If you have lost a loved one, make sure to leave a comment below. I read all of them, and I would love to hear a story about your loved one. And I believe that you'll find it really therapeutic to share it with somebody. And also, like I said, make sure to purchase Not Without Hope as a companion for you during this season. The holiday season can definitely be more difficult, whether it's the first season that you are experiencing without your loved one or the 10th season, because there's so many triggers that can pop up memories and thoughts in your mind that are good memories, right? They don't have to be bad memories, but they can be good memories that actually bring tears to your eyes and just bring back that reminder of loss again. So I hope that this was encouraging for you. I know this doesn't really feel like an encouraging topic, but I know it's a very real one. And while grief is not the same for everyone, and I definitely understand that, I know that there can be many parallels between believers who are experiencing loss, and I want you to know that I'm praying for you, and I am just wanting to be here for you. So make sure that you like and subscribe, leave a comment about your loved one, or just a memory that you've had, maybe a coping strategy that you have used that I didn't share here, and I will see you next time.